Hello everyone, welcome back. In today's Microsoft Excel tutorials video, we are going to continue our discussion with the Excel VBA. And in this video, we are going to see that simply how can we write a macro for ourselves. In the previous video, we have recorded a macro, and using that recorded macro code, we have made ourselves familiar with the interface of the VBA editor in Microsoft Excel. Now it's time that we begin with our first code. So since our basic idea is about macros, so we are going to focus our first code on macros only. And in this video, we are going to learn that how can we write a macro. Also, we are going to learn some important things about a macro and how can we save a macro enabled workbook or a macro workbook. Okay. So basically, I am in my workbook from the previous videos only, in which I have created some macros. Now, if you go to the developer tab and go to macros, you can just view the macros. You can see that there is this first macro and the procedure one we created. So it's only basically one macro right now. But what if you want more than one macro? Then how can you create it? You can go to Visual Basic, it could be any number of macros you can write. So you got to search for a module. The macros are already always present in a particular module. So in module 1 we have got this macro, and in module 2 if you see that there is no macro, so we are going to type our macro over here. If you go to this module 2 and you want to make sure that it is distinguished from other modules by saying that yes, I have written some macro over here, you can just go to this properties window and change its name as macro underscore write. That yes, I have written a macro. Okay, so yeah, that's macro write. And what is important for a macro is it must have a name and it must be in the form of a sub procedure. For the sub procedure here, you can omit the public or the private scope, but you gotta use the keyword sub for sub. That tells Visual Basic that yes, this is actually a sub procedure that needs to be executed. The next thing you gotta do is provide a name for your macro. Now, the naming convention that we used while creating a macro in Excel was we omitted using spaces, and instead of that we used underscores. So that is the same thing that we are going to do in this as well. So suppose it's going to be write VB macro. So this is going to be the name of my macro. And as soon as I click on enter, what happens is this sub gets converted into a blue color and its S is capitalized and I get this end sub line. This means that this VB editor has recognized this as some code and has changed it according to its conventions. Okay. Now, between the sub and end sub, what I can do is write anything that I want. Okay. Now, whatever I write would be the set of instructions that would be given to this macro. And whenever this macro is run or called, these instructions would be executed. Okay, so if I just write something, suppose I want to show a message box that says, you can see that all these things we have got, but I'm going to only provide it as a prompt, or you can see, say a message that hello, I am programming knowledge, and once you just end the double quotes, you can put a comma, and the next thing you have got is a number of the buttons that you can give, like abort, retry, ignore, application modal, critical, some default buttons, exclamation, information, help, and all these things. So this is kind of an information. So I'm going with VB information, put on a tab key, and if you just again put a comma, then there is this title which is optional, but I'm going to provide it with a title in double quotes again, greetings. And that's it. I can press on enter. So this is one message box that I have written. This message box would be shown whenever this macro is run. This is the actual condition or the actual instruction given to this macro. Now how can I run this macro? There are two ways. Either you can simply use this button or press the shortcut F5, or you can just go to run, and here is the same option. So you can just do this, and you see this is the message box that I have got. Greetings was the title that I gave it. VB information was its type, that's why I have got this I. And this is the message: hello, I am programming knowledge. You can click on OK. Now again you can go to Excel sheet, and again if you want to run this macro, either you can use the VBA or you can go to the macros tab. Here you can see, right, VB macro is present. If you want to run it from here, you can simply click on run, and the same thing it does again. Okay, so that's how you can create a macro using the VB code. That was a simple macro. Now this is only just one line instruction, but usually the macros don't contain one line instructions. They can contain many instructions or many lines of code. So suppose you have another line, say you want to show another message box, and this time it shows that I am a YouTube channel. This is the kind of the message I want it to show, in double quotes of course. I put a comma, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going for VB question. Okay, this is basically to show you that what these different kinds of buttons can do. You can check it as VB question, put a comma, and its title is question, like this. Basically it could be anything that you want. So if you just try to run it, then what happens is, first you get this message box that greetings, hello, I am programming knowledge. You click on OK, and then you get the second line, that is question, I am a YouTube channel. Okay, now one thing you must have noticed, that in both these message boxes we got different icons. One was a information and then was a question. That was because of this VB question. So this defines the type of the message box. Also in both of these messages boxes we got only OK button, but what if you want more than one button? Say you want both OK and cancel buttons. So you can just go to message box, type something, say sentence. This is a simple sentence. OK, put a comma, and then there is this option of VB, OK, cancel. You can put a tab, put a comma in double quotes, info. Okay, and then if you just run this macro again, what happens? First this thing, information, then this thing, question, then this thing, sentence, with two options, OK and cancel. So this is how you can simply write a VB macro. Now let us close this VBA. Now what happens is, this sheet or this workbook has some macros in it. What if I try to save it by pressing the shortcut Control S? Then it asks for a place. Okay, then I'm going to keep the default settings, and if I click on save, then this is the thing I get. It gives me an error that to save a file with these features, which is basically the macro features, click no and then choose a macro enabled file, or to continue saving it as a macro free workbook, click yes. Now if you want to click yes, then all the macros that we have created would be destroyed and it would be saved as a normal workbook. But if you want to save it as a macro enabled workbook, or want to make sure that whatever macros you have created must be present, you should click on no. So just click on no, and from the save as type, which is basically Excel workbook right now, you can go and select the second option, which is Excel macro enabled workbook. If you just select on it, you can click on save, and see, there is no error. It has been saved successfully. So that is all in today's video. I hope you all have enjoyed it, and I also hope that you all have learned something new from this. Thanks for watching.